Dolphins. And let's well, I've been trying to get the spring and rainy day in spring and late afternoon winter video out. But I think I keep putting in spoilers and such. But we do have a video here, it's almost time. I'm also working on the other video as well that I need to put out. I just gotta figure out a way on how to actually do that. But anyway, let's go with this video. So a quick 6 second video, which is fine. It's Gryffindor. It's basically from the trailer itself. So there's nothing new, it's just a quick 6 second video. You can find that on the Hogwarts Legacy community. Also, there's a calling all wizards and witches to join the official Hogwarts Legacy Discord. I'll have a link for that down below. Yeah, I'm joined, so. Global releases for the Deluxe Edition, which comes out tomorrow. Yeah, it comes out tomorrow. I'm getting it. Both PS5 and Xbox Series X version. Congratulations to Los Angeles. You're getting it on, well, virtually the 6 at 9 p.m. And again on the 9th as well. Also, Warner Bros. Entertainment and Porky Games, along with Avalanche Studios, might want to, get on the phone to Steam and Epic Game Store and find out why they're holding Hogwarts Legacy hostage until the 8th. For everyone to the right of my cursor. And then, because everyone to the left gets it on the 7th on PC. It's actually held hostage on PC for Australians, New Zealanders, Philippines, Japan, China, India, South Africa, Spain, Italy, and United Kingdom tomorrow. Yeah, it's held hostage, guys. Don't know why. Even though it's like, oh, it's not actually the 7th in the US. Excuse me, Steam, Epic. As soon as it hits 0, it's supposed to be able to be played and downloaded. Or downloaded and played. Also, those who are actually wondering, yes, PlayStation 5 does actually now have a pre-download. And people have been reporting that online. So, go download, check your console right now. Excuse me. I just got up. Anyway. Without further ado, thank you to Hogwarts Legacy, the team behind Hogwarts Legacy themselves, which is Avalanche Studios and Avalanche Software. Warner Brothers Games Entertainment. Warner Brothers Entertainment copyright team. Yeah, I'm including them because I don't want to have my channel removed or struck down. Also, Porky Games as well, for both a rainy spring night and a late winter afternoon. There is something in both, though. I'm starting to get the feeling of homesickness, and even though, yes, I'm home at my real house, but I'm homesickness for Hogwarts and Hogsmeade as well. And yes, if everyone actually does understand this, actually, James and everyone else will be able to understand this, because this, I've recognized this from their playthrough. When they play from the 2-hour event that they went to. From the event they went to play Hogwarts Legacy for 2 hours. Make 2 hours of Hogwarts Legacy? I would have gone, yeah, just give me 40 minutes. Why? I'm exploring Hogwarts, it's gonna take me a while. White birds are on a flight pattern. We got the care of magical creatures here. We got the Owlery. We got Hogwarts itself. Beautiful. We got the fountain. We got Ravenclaw and Badger. Ravenclaw, Hufflepuffs. Emblems. And yeah, it's one more day. Actually, no, correction. Let me rephrase that. One more night. One more night for the Deluxe Edition pickup. Oh yeah. I'm in that mood. I'm in that mood. The hype train is pulling into the station tomorrow. But yeah, I love this. This makes a perfect, actually, it's perfect background. Matter of fact, anything from these videos make perfect background. But this just pulls it together nicely. And yes, there's those birds are on flight patterns, but as soon as they get here, they disappear. I don't see them going that way or coming across here. They just disappear. Watch. And gone. Ooh. We know this area. I think we know this area. But I can point out one statue here. When it comes into the view. So we got, I think there's a page here for this.
Yeah.
Nah, that can't be. That can't be Merlin, can it? That can't be Merlin. That can't be Merlin. It just can't be. Can it? It just can't be Merlin.
Yeah, I got the recess.
It can't be Merlin. That can't be Merlin. I'm looking at my notes. My notes are up on my second monitor. Yeah, but that is an Okami. That's an Okami. The background, you're probably wondering, oh, it's not the actual Hogsmeade background. It's an artist rendition of Hogsmeade, okay? Before we even get a look. Even before we got a look at Hogsmeade and the Haunted Hogsmeade trailer. They actually did. They did that, so that's your freebie when you link your accounts together. I'll put up the portkey thing. It's all in the description down below. But yes, that is an Okami statue. I'm still homesick for Hogwarts. And yeah, that has water feature. That's got a water feature. I mean, this makes it beautiful. It's a great shot as well. I'm going to be exploring this part. We have the greenhouse and the library. Yeah, those stained glass windows. Yeah. Those are from inside the library. We can't see out though. Or in, for that matter. But I love all the lighting effects. Ooh, I love these. Because that's the central hub building, right there. Because this
is one of the greenhouses. This is the library. And this is an archway that we can actually come through. I'm going to be exploring this part. I feel like I got hair in my mouth. Yeah. No, I haven't been eating Betty Bot's every flavor. Jelly bean. Right, there was air in my mouth. Oh, gross. Ugh, I didn't mean gross. Ugh, make me wish I wish there wasn't. Actually, now it's now making me wish there was a Betty Bot flavor, every flavor jelly bean and pear. Really don't want that. Really don't want that. Yeah, we're passing through Dittany. I can tell that's the greenhouse because of the dragon that's on top. Yeah, my notes do say that. Ooh, we know this. And also, pay close attention to this when you re-watch this video by yourself. This actually has two things. So this could be... let me just zoom in. It could be one and a three, or a J and W. Now I'm going to say it's one and three, because that's what it looks like. And James, when he was host as well, with Chandler Wood and such on the Gameplay Showcase one, you can actually see that video. He pointed this place out, and yeah, I'm agreeing. Though I can point out the other place that we were at down there. Or was that another place? No two places are the same, aren't they? It's just like Hogwarts is filled with unknown magic, ancient magic, ancient and powerful magic, which means you've got vanishing stairs and classrooms not being in the right place, doors not opening, doors leading to just a wall. It's like they open it. Yeah, I'm going to class, bye. Oh, really didn't need to hit that wall. There's doors that like to play tricks and everything else. You gotta tickle the door in the right spot. And yeah, I'm quoting Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone here. Because you gotta remember, Harry was a first year. We're a fifth year. We start Hogwarts in our fifth year. Guessing this has something to do with the Baziers, I should say, because we got one, two unlit, and then there's probably a third and fourth one that's not lit. So we've probably got something to do with that. That means Incendio would come into play. But exactly how? A watering can stop over watering, please. We got Hogshead inside. We got Zonkers. We have Ollivander. It is right here. For all those who actually want to know, we have an ancestor of Ollivander's in this game. Someone from the Ollivander family. We do have the free broomsticks and the quality Quidditch supplies. The reason why I can say that with confidence is because this is the quality Quidditch supplies. Oh, and that lock is also magically locked, which means we can use a lower more on it. And the reason why I can say we can use a lower more on it, because if you actually watch everyone else's quest gameplay, it's virtually the same quest, it's just their different type of playthroughs. So one's gone through with wands blazing, the others have gone through sneakily. I think I might go through sneakily. just to satisfy that itch for, I want to know what it's like to go sneakily through, but I also want to go through with what's blazing. Doriana, blaze of glory! I really wish the Ancient One was actually one that you'd get. Also, I don't know if we're getting the physical map. I'll be looking tomorrow anyway. I'll be making sure tomorrow, actually. For all those who are getting the digital copy, congratulations, you'll be playing that 9 to 10.5 hours early before me. Yeah, I need to let the game install on my Xbox Series X. I really wish I had a PS5, because then I'd be hooking that up and streaming straight from it. But alas, I don't have a PS5. Get that in 2 months. That's even better. But yeah. There's also free broomsticks on the right-hand side. Just here. They're coming into view. That watering can is still watering. Bad watering can. You're over-watering the dentine. We have either Madame Potterfee's tea room, or we have Rose Lee's tea room. I don't know which one it is, because there's two in Hogsmeade. This is probably one of them. I can't say with confidence this is from Haunted Hogsmeade, because we do actually come in through this way, which means the Hogsmeade post office is on the right hand side when we enter. Hangus of Woodcraft statue is also in front here. If you know this street from the State of Play, it's where one of the trolls is. Comes in, just demolishes the building completely. With a big Hulk smash roar. Like, really, it's like, I'm just charging through, buildings no more. And then just roar. Yeah, I love this. This. Yeah, I got that feeling for of homesickness for Hogwarts and Hogsmeade. Especially when you've been watching the movies. Rereading the books for the 200th time or something. I know everyone else is, so I probably read my books 1,000 times plus, maybe. I know I just started. Prince of Azkaban, I've been slow reading because I want to enjoy these. I want to enjoy the books. I'm up to the night bus, and if I remember correctly, the night bus was not around. Before 18 something. So the night bus might be around now, in 1890. So we don't know. All I know is that we get an acceptance letter. Is that a Niffler? That's a Niffler. That's a Niffler. Yeah, that's a Niffler. There's no cancel. That looks like a Niffler to me. That looks like a Niffler, but I can't tell because of the tail. Yay! Sharp and tug make galleons for all the fire whiskey. And I don't mean for all the fire whiskey. I can drink in the day. You know the meme of sharp and take my money with Fry going, sharp and take my money. Yeah, this is me going, sharp and take all my galleons. Actually, I should do a small video and turn that into a gift. Sharp and take my galleons. Actually, I'm gonna do that. After this is finished, I'm gonna do that. gonna turn that into a GIF. I'm gonna do it. I'm sorry. It has to be done. But yeah, I can't wait to visit the Hogshead Inn, which is right here. I do know the magic needs in Hogsmeade. Dogweed and Death Cats is also another shop in Hogsmeade. Both of them are different. One's a green grocer, the other one actually sells exotic plants and seeds and everything else, including Death Cats themselves. Pippin's in Hogsmeade, so it's gonna be great to actually see him. It's gonna be great to actually see Pippin. Also, the clothing store owner, it's gonna be great to actually see him. Who else? Ollivander himself, not the one from the movies, as in the one from the Harry Potter movies, but his ancestor, it's gonna be great to see him. What else? I know there's something else I'm missing. Free Room 6. It's gonna be a great place to visit. What else? There's something else I am missing as well. Not quality Quidditch supplies, because that's gonna be on top of my list to actually go to see. The bookstore for our books. And yeah, I do mean for our books. It's like, yes, we have our wand, we have an ancient magic wand. But we also get an actual one. And I was talking about the Magic Neep, and here's the Magic. There's Magic Neep. There is a greengrocer. A magic greengrocer. Magical greengrocer for the Wizarding World. We also have a graveyard of sorts here. Ooh. Why am I getting flashbacks to Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire with Wormwood lifting up Bone of the Father? We also have a shack here. I love the lighting. The lightning in this, it's peaceful to me. With thunder. This should have been called a rainy spring night. This should have been called a thunderstorm spring night. And I do mean that. I could just have this part going continuously just as a video itself. It's peaceful. For me, it's peaceful. If you were growing up as a kid and you had thunderstorms and such, I was like, okay, oh, it's God moving. No, it's actually the sound of after the lightning. And that one was really close. I love it. Especially if it lights up the sky beautifully. Also, if it does actually cause a blackout and you do have backup power, hey, congratulations. But if that backup power actually goes away, well, it's off the bed anyway. Excuse me. Oh, damn fangle muggle device. There. Someone has been doing ASMR videos of Harry Potter. Ooh, where are you at? Oh. Okay, Adam, you got a shout out. I am gonna be watching that video. Also again, I'd like to thank Hogwarts Legacy, team behind Hogwarts Legacy, which is Avalanche Studios, Avalanche Software, Warner Bros. Games, Warner Bros. Entertainment, Portkey Games, and Warner Bros. Entertainment Copyright Team. Let's go through. I really hate these smuggle devices. Give me an owl. Please. Just give me an owl and parchment that I can actually write letters to and everything else and get a quick reply instead of using a mobile phone. I really hate devices. Especially ones that let you communicate. They suck. Oh, that's a nice view. It's a nice view, it's just not great. It's not beautiful either, it's just a nice view. I'm guessing that's a Ninja Magic spot down there. Just down there. Something in my email app. That's better. Ooh. Someone's doing something for a group. Ooh, I know where we are. I know where we are. There's no mistake in that little banister there. But we do have, if you've watched Gameplay Showcase 2, and Ben Snow was actually over here. He was over this way, past Hogwarts. So he was somewhere around that section beforehand. Because there is a hamlet over that way. I'm not sure if we can visit that little island or something. I'm not sure, but I think that's a chest sitting right there, right where my cursor is. This is the stairway from the boathouse. And also, Fantastic Beasts Where to Find Them cases, that was never released in Australia, as far as I know of. There are some things that aren't released, and I'm still waiting on Harry Potter the Magic Awaken, so there is that. Though I really wish Harry Potter Hogwarts Mystery was available for PC, because then I'd be playing it. And let me check my note. I had to pause here because my notes actually do say this is the staircase from the boathouse. I'm actually happy to actually use these to the boathouse. So yeah, this is gonna be fun. Also, we are swinging the camera across to look at Hogwarts Castle. Oh, now that's beautiful. That is beautiful. Hogwarts in winter. especially with the greenhouse here. And yeah, that is the central hub. That's the central hub right there. They're the greenhouses. I'm sorry. We all know this view. It's coming up. But this is this is outside Hogwarts. But I don't know which path. That's the problem. Do all the Harry Potter books actually have them? Yeah, they do. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, according to these, the mats that we do actually get, well, the only mat we get in all the books. So we have a little map here. I did a breakdown video on all these, so they're all different. We've got the Forbidden Forest. Whomping Willow is not in anywhere in these games, in Hogwarts Legacy. The Quidditch Stadium is, or the Quidditch Pitch. The Broom Shed. Area of flat lawn for flying lessons. We actually saw that in James's gameplay. The Black Lake does have the squid. There is a video somewhere online I'm trying to find again that actually shows the cave with the image of the squid, the giant squid. Ooh, also, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for riding the Hogwarts Express or any train for that matter. The final stop is Hogsmeade Station. All those who are getting off at Hogsmeade Station, please disembark. We'd like to thank you for travelling with us. Please disembark at Hogsmeade Station. This is your final stop. Yes, it does take a whole day. Nearly. When does the Hogwarts Express leave? Letters from no one. Dual person master sorting, I know. Journey from Platinum 9 Frequency. Oh, and we are walking up from, Harry's last message, blah 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 blah. Ah, 11 o'clock. So basically, well, by the time they get from King's Cross Station in London, it's 6? Maybe a bit more? I don't know. That is entirely weird. Because you have to catch the Hogs... Yeah, that we have the Winged Boars. We have to catch the Hogwarts Express from London and King's Cross. Harry had to in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. Sorcerer's Stone for you in the US. The train leaves at 11. You gotta be there to catch the train. But we, in the trailer and such that we've seen, oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. But in the trailer and such, we're in a carriage. And no, I'm not going to spoil anything in the game either. People have been posting videos and such. I'm not going to be spoiling it. I'm not going to spoil it. I'm like, yeah, I know your video exists. I'm not watching it. It's like with the achievements. Yes, we know they exist. list. I forgot about them already. That's how great I am with the achievements / trophies. I've already forgotten about them. Oh, is this? Hogwarts Great Hall. Oh, that looks at things. Just that fireplace. Well, actually, I can't say this is the Great Hall in Hogwarts. For all those who actually are wondering, yes, Hogwarts Mystery does actually show us the Great Hall. In LEGO Harry Potter Years 1 to 4, and I think 5 to 7, we also get to go into the Great Hall itself. But the one thing about the LEGO Harry Potter games, the castle does not match up. You gotta remember, those games were released for PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 well and truly before the Xbox One came out, along with the PS4. Though in Australia, the PS3 and PS4 were quite the same price as a Blu-ray player, brand new. I wanted a PS4 so I can play both Spider-Man games before they went across to PlayStation 5. Finished Spider-Man Miles Morales. Beautiful game. But, oh, I think I'm already full from the Great Hall here. We got introduced to Feast. Yummy. Hey, can you pass the tiramisu, please? Can you? Thanks. You down there, can you, pass me the, that trickle fudge, please? Awesome. Also, I love these windows. I want just these, so I can slap on the bottom of my window. Also, that's the ceiling. It's enchanted to look like the night sky. Actually, the ceiling is enchanted to actually look like the sky outside. I don't know whose hut this is. I don't even know if we're still on Hogwarts grounds. Funny, huh? Oh, bundle up, we got the blizzard coming in. Also, I'd like to point out, who hangs clothes out to dry while it's winter? Hang him inside, you have a fire. You have a fireplace, hang him inside to dry in front of that fireplace. All of that cadaver then. Like I said, I don't know if we're still in Hogwarts grounds in this part, but this is one of the cottages or shacks or whatever we can see. Also, there are other hamlets and such dotted around, so we'll be able to visit those as soon as we have our magical menagerie open up and running. I'm gonna be enjoying flying around that Onyx Hippogriff. And yes, I know a lot of people have had the game early. One person put, they've in their 6-hour playthrough, they've only been through 1% of Hogwarts Castle. I'm just gonna explore Hogwarts Castle first. know this store. I talked about it before. Dogweed and death caps. I can't wait to visit this store. As well. I really wish we could climb over here. Because there is a shack up there, up on this thing behind the store. Though actually it looks like it's built into the rock face itself. So if you keep seeing the flickering, it's my OBS has scene transitions is fade. I have no idea how to change that. And plus I don't want to change the card either, so there is that. And also I'm gonna have to try and fix my microphone. That should be that. Is that better? That should be better now. You're not hearing the fan. You shouldn't be hearing the fan from my laptop. Yeah. So there's the check. Please don't cast bomb butter and such inside it. So, with the room requirement, I'm surprised that Harry and Co, like, oh, shit, it's Umbridge outside? Quick. We need the room requirement to be something else. Like, just a lounge area that we can all just sit in, just hang out. Quick, grab the, come to the lounge, shove it in the room. And we're back at Hogwarts. I was like, they could have just done that. Why did they do that? It would suit the name perfectly. I was like, yeah, we're just, oh, hi Professor, we're just lounging around in here. But this isn't, no. But this is supposed to be, no. But isn't this supposed to be Dumbledore Army meets? Dumbledore's army. Please. Why would we have Dumbledore's army meeting in here? Room requirement gave us the lounge. We're just sitting here chatting. Considering we're in our owls and you're not allowing us to learn offensive magic. I wonder how the Minister for Magic would find that. How would he take it? I don't think he'll take it very well. Because if we fail our owls for the defense against the dark arts, Professor, you are held responsible. An average would actually be held responsible if everyone in their 50 failed their defense against the dark arts. I'm actually gonna pull this up. Centaur and the Snake. Mysteries, no. Out of the frying pan. Ah, just saw. looking for Hogwarts Legacy support, I will link below. Let me just find, where is that? Oh, here we go. And yes, I'm gonna quote this. Harry Potter and the Order of Phoenix. Professor Toffee asks, I heard from my dear friend, you can produce a Patronus. For a bonus point, Harry raised one, looked at Deborah Ambridge, and imagined her being sacked. Expect a Patronum. His silver stack erupted from the end of his wand and cantered the length of the hole. All the examiners looked to watch its progress, and when it dissolved into silver mist, Professor Toffee clapped his vein and nodded hands enthusiastically. Excellent, he said. Well, very well, Potter. You may go. Because Harry just in Order of the Phoenix, Harry achieved an L for outstanding. And there was nothing Umbridge could actually do. Because if she threatened those who were actually doing the L exam of the students, she would be called into be fired, one snap, and told never to come back, don't even bother. Because as soon as you try and get another one, we'll know. And every other agency will know. Though I wonder how many wands she actually has confiscated over the years. I mean, she might have a nice good collection of wands that she could use. But if she's caught with a wand after it's being snapped, yeah. It ain't gonna be pretty. But anyway, everything's going to be linked down below, including the link to Hogwarts Legacy's Discord. And yes, I do love that. You claim your glasses and you still have to... You still have to claim them. Everything's going to be linked down below, which it already is. So, thank you for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the bell notification for more videos. And I will see you tomorrow with my bonus items to review. Yes, I am getting Hogwarts Legacy Deluxe Editions on PS5 and Xbox Series X. Also, I did mention the map. I don't know if it's true or not. I have no idea. I'll find out tomorrow. We'll all find out tomorrow anyway. For those with deluxe editions and the collector's editions. So, yay. Stay safe wherever you are.